Good afternoon, brothers and sisters. Welcome to our holy hour. It's a time that we are going to be with our Lord to pray and to especially remember. And it says in the gospel of today, Jesus Christ is the true bread from heaven, the one who can truly satisfy our hunger, satisfy our heart, transform us, and give us the gift of eternal life. Let us take this moment to pray for our brothers and sisters who have been affected by the coronavirus, and also pray for our family members that the Lord may continue to provide for them and keep them safe during this time of uncertainty. I invite you now to sing with our music minister the opening hymn.
Every song. Oh, divine Jesus, lonely today in so many tabernacles, without visitor or worshiper, I offer you my poor but loving heart. May its every beat be a prayer of love for you. You are ever watching under the sacramental veils. In your love, you never sleep and are never weary of your vigil for sinners. Oh, good Jesus, I love you. I am truly sorry for ever having offended you. Oh, lonely Jesus, may my heart be as a lamp, the light of which shall burn for you alone. Bless me, O Jesus. Come spiritually into my soul and fill my heart with love for you. Make me completely yours. Take this sinful heart of mine and guide it through this veil of tears. Heart of Jesus, hear me. When I draw my parting breath, when my eyes shall close in death, then, sweet Jesus, be near to me. Heart of Jesus, hear me. Watch, sacramental sentinel. Watch for the weary world, for the erring soul, and for your poor lonely child. Protect us all from the coronavirus. Divine healer, give health to those who are ill. Profoundly I adore you, Jesus. I acknowledge that you are true God and true man. Accept this hour of adoration by which I would make reparation for the indifference of so many who pass before you, before your holy temple and tabernacles, where hour after hour you dwell with loving impatience for those who never enter to adore you, but who, like the Israelites in the wilderness, seem by their difference to loathe the bread of heaven. With all my strength, I worship you. With all my love, I cling to you. With all my soul, I long for you. And fear not no more to fall away from you. Jesus, undying love, who seeks me, you who died for love of me, King in all your splendor, come to me. Depart no more, dear Lord, from me. O God, most precious and most priceless one, O God, most glorious uncreated one, O God, eternal beatific one, O God, O infinite and hidden one, O God, immense, O God, the living one, you, wisdom of the everlasting one, with all my heart I give myself to you, O patient love, who wearies not of me. Call me to ever follow you, O bear with me, till I lose myself in you. O bear with me, till I found myself in you. Please respond to each invocation. I love you, oh my God. God the Holy Spirit, I love you, oh my God. Holy Trinity, one God, I love you, oh my God. You who are infinite love, I love you, oh my God. You who did first love me, I love you, oh my God. You ask me to love you, I love you, oh my God. With all my heart, I love you, oh my God. With all my soul, I love you, oh my God. With all my mind, I love you, oh my God. With all my strength, I love you, oh my God. Above all position and honors, I love you, oh my God. Above all pleasures and enjoyments, I love you, oh my God. More than myself, I love you, oh my God. More than anything belonging to me, I love you, oh my God. More than all my relatives and friends, I love you, oh my God. More than all people and angels, I love you, oh my God. Above all created things in heaven and on earth, I love you, oh my God. Only for yourself, I love you, oh my God. Because you are the sovereign God, I love you, oh my God. Because you are infinitely worthy of being loved, I love you, oh my God. Even should you try me with trouble and misfortune, I love you, oh my God. In wealth and in poverty, I love you, oh my God. In prosperity and adversity, I love you, oh my God. In health and in sickness, I love you, oh my God. In time and in eternity, I love you, oh my God. In union with that love with which the saints love you, I love you, oh my God. In union with that love with which all the angels love you in heaven, I love you, oh my God. In union with that love with which the Blessed Virgin loves you, I love you, oh my God. In union with that love with which you love yourself eternally, I love you, oh my God. In this sacrament, sweet Jesus, you give your flesh and blood with your soul and your divinity as our own most precious food. Yes, Jesus, I believe it. In your presence I adore, and with all my heart I love you. Help me love you more and more. O Mary, you always shine on our path as a sign of salvation and of hope. We entrust ourselves to you, health of the sick, who at the cross took part in Jesus' pain, keeping your faith firm. You, salvation of the American people and of all the world, know what we need, and we are sure you will provide, so that, as in Cana of Galilee, we may return to joy and to feasting after this time of trial. Help us, Mother of Divine Love, to conform to the will of the Father and to do as we are told by Jesus, who has taken upon himself our sufferings and carried our sorrows to lead us through the cross to the joy of the resurrection. Amen. Christ with me, Christ before me, Christ behind me, Christ in me, Christ beneath me, Christ above me, Christ on my right, Christ on my left, Christ when I lie down, Christ when I sit down, Christ when I rise, Christ in the heart of everyone who thinks of me, Christ in the mouth of everyone who speaks of me, Christ in every eye that sees me, Christ in every ear that hears me. Brothers and sisters, as we often, when we are praying, we could forget to pray for ourselves. In the midst of this pandemic, sometimes we forget on whom we must focus. Our focus must be on our Savior, Jesus Christ. Let us take this moment of silence to pray for ourselves, to pray for our spiritual life, to pray for our health. Pray that the Lord, the Eucharistic Lord, may come to you, stay with you, live with you, protect you, and guide you during this time. We know Jesus, the true bread that come from heaven. As Israelite asked Jesus in the gospel of today, give us always the bread of life. Brothers and sisters, Jesus always gives us the bread of life. He gives himself to us in the most basic food, the most ordinary food that we need. In receiving this food spiritually, he transforms our life and gives us the seed of eternal life that can grow within us. Let us ask the Lord to accompany us on our journey to paradise, on our journey to eternal life. generous God, fill us with compassion and concern for others, young and old, that we may look after one another in these challenging days, bring healing to those who are sick with the virus and be with their families. May those who have died rest in your eternal embrace. Comfort their family and friends. Strengthen and protect all medical professionals caring for the sick and all who work in our medical facilities. Give wisdom to leaders in healthcare and governance, that they may make the right decisions for the well-being of people. We pray in gratitude for all those in our country who will continue to work in the days ahead in so many fields of life for the sake of us all. Bless them and keep them safe. O God of creation and life, we place ourselves in your protection. May the mantle of your peace enfold us this day and tomorrow. Saint Joseph, pray for us. Our Lady of Guadalupe, pray for us. May all the saints of God pray for us. Amen. O sweet Jesus, let me lay at your sacred feet my daily share of joys, struggles and sorrows, hopes and fears. And you, in the stillness of your sanctuary, gather them to your most sacred heart. Ease my doubts, calm my fears, and grant that every day I may become more closely united to you. O heart of Jesus, in the most blessed sacrament, overflowing with love and charity, I turn over to your mercy all of my negligence and my sins. I offer you all my labors and sufferings, my sorrows and my miseries. I recommend to you my life and my death. Amen. Now, brothers and sisters, let us remember in our prayer all of the healthcare workers who have been at the front line fighting coronavirus, and help us to regain our health. Loving God, we place into your care all our doctors, nurses, and healthcare workers. Give them courage of heart and strength of mind and body. Keep them safe from harm. May they know our deep gratitude for all they are doing to heal and help those affected by the coronavirus. God of all consolation, may they know your protection and peace. Bless them in these challenging days and bless their families as well. Amen. Let us pray for the priests as they exercise the ministry in during this time. Especially pray for those who are providing the eternal bread of life, the Eucharist, to our sick people during this dark time, and never weary of going out to visit the sick, either at their home or at some healthcare facilities. Eternal God, be with our priests this day as they seek to minister to your people. May you be a guiding and protective presence with them as they bring the consolation and hope of your word and the grace and nourishment of Eucharist to those entrusted to their care. Grant them the strength of mind and body. Keep them safe to do your will, and give them the courage and peace to face each day with trust and confidence in you. Into your hands, O God, we commend them. Fill them with your grace and healing. Amen. Brothers and sisters, now at home, I invite you to kneel and sing with us the Tentum Ego. You have given them bread from heaven,
having within it all sweetness.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, you gave us the Eucharist as the memorial of your suffering and death. May our worship of this sacrament of your body and blood help us to experience the salvation you want for us, and the peace of the kingdom, where you live with the Father and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Please repeat after me the divine praises. Blessed be God.
Blessed be God.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be his holy name.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be Jesus Christ, true God and true man.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be the name of Jesus.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most sacred heart.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be his most precious blood.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be Jesus in the most holy sacrament of the altar.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Blessed be the Holy Spirit, the Paraclete.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy.
Blessed be the great Mother of God, Mary most holy.
Blessed be her holy and immaculate conception. Blessed be her glorious Assumption.
Blessed be her glorious Assumption.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be the name of Mary, Virgin and Mother.
Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be Saint Joseph, her most chaste spouse.
Blessed be God in his angels and in his saints.
Blessed be God.
Thank you, brothers and sisters, for being with us during this holy hour and praying together. I give you, tomorrow, we'll have Mass stream. We'll have Mass at 9. We hope we can be together again for Mass at 9 and holy hour at the same time, at 3 o'clock. May the Lord continue to bless you and keep you in his care and be safe. I invite you now to sing with us the final hymn, Holy God, We Praise Thy Name.